So, how to play the VK100-01P. Let's go through the basics. We have modules. I have selected ventilation, gun rammer, and turbocharger. Turbocharger is because I need to get a little bit of engine boost because it's very slow in random battles. You could also select an improved hardening. Very good choice. Gives you better, more hit points and better suspension. And for that, we have obviously the sides need to be protected, very vertical. So you need to angle everything. You have the cupola you need to hide. And let's play a few games and let's see how it is. But before we play a few games, go in and exclude some maps. You do not want to go on open maps. So the open maps I don't want to play on is probably Malinovka. Yeah. And it is properly Provahovka. There were, if I could exclude more maps, I would probably exclude Sand River, I would exclude Steps, I would exclude, what else, Highway. Nah, that's pretty much a good town in it, so no need for that. Yeah, El Haluf maybe, yeah. I selected Malinovka, Provahovka. You don't want to be caught out in the open in the VK100. It sucks. So let's play a few games and let's see how we do. How do we angle the tank and how do we bounce shots? Let's go. First map we get is Mountain Pass in a Tier 10 game. That's not going to be very fun, but let's see what we can do. Should be able to do reasonably well. So, where do we go? I usually go to the bridge, or I go up here. I go to the bridge this time because, yeah, let's try and see what how that works. Hope we don't meet the Jagdpanzer 100. And we see a tiny tank on the other side, so that's gonna be okay so far. Let's hope there's no tank destroyers. Checking to see if anyone was there, no one's there. Shot hit. Shot went through, and someone wants to help us, that's nice. He survived that, that was a bit strange. Look at that, we angled pretty deep, so we are checking the lower front plates. We need to go a little bit more. These shots. So can't get a few shots into him. There we go. Move, move, move. A little bit up. Actually quite good at shooting, so he's keep pinning us. It's not very fun. Explosive in so we can kill him the next shot, no matter where we hit him. Wir sind bewegungsunfähig. So we blocked 1,700 damage so far. I did 1,800 damage, not so good, but we'll see if we can get more damage in. Looks like we're winning quite nicely, so. Shot, but it works because the gun is quite good on this tank. If you have a nice crew, you can also shoot without aiming too much. That worked quite nicely for us. Metal? Oh, got a steel wall. Nice. What did that do? That was quite nice, I guess. And we also, I'm also trying to raise my rating on the vehicle. As you can see. You can see we are... Okay, that doesn't work very well today. We are number 96 out of, well, a lot of people playing this tank, so we're doing quite well, moving up. I'm trying to aim to get to top 20, but let's try a few more battles and let's see if we can improve on this battle. Just 50 TP over here is probably moving up behind the hill, so that's good. We can move up and meet him and say hello. So we go tire 8 against tire 8. Then there's only what? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 tire 8s. So let's get those out of the way. There's the Ulysses. Where is he going? Tank pretty effectively. That's interesting. Should be pretty much alone out there.
Commandant aufgefallen.
So, we need to get rid of this guy before we can push the 50 TP. Wide. Turn the turret away when you're moving up against people. Yeah, look at that. He cannot pin the turret when you turn it away. Then let's see if there's anyone here. Maybe we can get some friends. There we go. Snapshot you can do with this tank quite well as well. Again, turn your turret away so you cannot take your weak spot. Weak spot is the cupola. Not want to show it to people. How good is this tank? Well, the turret is quite good, so it's a new tire 7 Italian tank. Let's take We can also ram with this tank. That's the fun part. If you ram like this, you do quite a lot of damage. Then you can actually, yeah. There we go, and ramming again. A little more damage. Yeah. Let's go to the middle. And we need to watch out here. There's most likely tank destroyers camped up here. As always, in this game. Where did that go? It's going down, so it's out of range. Need the T-44, so it's also dead. People are dying fast now, so we need to move up and hurry. Well, hurry is so much you can just say in this tank, but we're certainly moving up. Now, we want to angle towards this area, because we know there is tank destroyers up there. Or, well, there's a strong chance there's at least one tank destroyer up there, since there's three tank destroyers left. One is spotted down here. And there must be someone up here. There must be. I cannot believe it if there's not. There's... yeah, there we go. Super Hellcat is up there, and he cannot pin me from that angle. Not that tank. This entire 7 tank, he will not pin me. Where is the rest of the tanks? Super Hellcat got killed by the Brask. I don't know. The GSOR is shooting at me from where? Down there. So nice angle I have. So we know where all the tanks are, roughly. So where is the GSOR? GSOR. Where are you? There we go. And I bounced one shot, because I'm a little bit angled down, then they can't shoot at my lower front plate. He's behind a killable house, I guess. Yeah, behind a killable house. Nice. Come on, load. Ah, he died. Where's the GSOR? GSOR? He's down there somewhere. Shot at me from that range, unless he ran to the loot. Aim. Let's shoot. There we go, because long range shots need to aim completely in before you let the shot go. Only close range shots, and we did 2400 damage, 1500 blocked, and 800 spotting, so not too bad. It's quite okay for a tirade. We could have done more, but we are on a slow tank, so if you want to go faster, you need to play mediums or faster heavy tanks. And that's it. That's how to play the Beacon 100. You can always, if you like the video, give me a like.